Hi friends, this is Mona. Welcome to Miracle Creatures channel. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel, like, comment and click the bell icon to get the latest videos. Natural history locomotion. Because of their body structure and their feathered covering, birds are the best flyers among animals, better than insects and bats. There are, however, considerable differences in ability among various birds. Penguins cannot fly, instead spending much of their time in the water swimming with their paddle-like wings. Birds such as ostriches and emus have rudimentary wings but are permanently afoot. At the other extreme, long-winged swifts and frigate birds move from their perches only to fly, never to walk. Most birds alternate some walking or swimming with their flying. Birds usually fly when they have any considerable distance to travel. There are exceptions, however. The mountain quail of California make their annual migrations up and down the mountains on foot. The guillemots of the Greenland coast migrate southward by swimming. They begin their journey before the young have grown their flight feathers and before some of the adults at least have regrown their recently molted ones. The Adelie penguins may ride northward on drifting ice floes. At the approach of nesting time, they swim back to the Antarctic continent and then walk over the ice to their breeding grounds many miles inland. Flight birds fly by flapping their wings, steering mainly with their tails. Compared to the parts of an airplane, a bird's wing acts as both wing and propeller. The basal part of the wing supplies most of the supporting surface, the wingtip most of the propelling force. A bird's wing has many adjustable features. It can be shortened or lengthened by flexion, the feathers of the tip can be spread or closed, the angle of the whole wing or its parts, on one side or both, can be altered. All of these adjustments make the aerodynamics of a bird's wing much more complicated than those of the airplane. Consequently, the flight of a bird is much more varied and adaptable. The types of flight found in birds vary considerably, and different types of wings correlate with different types of flight. At least two major types of modifications for gliding or soaring are found. Albatrosses and some other seabirds have long, narrow wings and take advantage of winds over the oceans, whereas some vultures and hawks have broad wings with slotted tips that permit more use of updrafts and winds deflected by hills. Short, broad wings are characteristic of chicken-like birds, which fly up with a rush of rapid wing beats. Birds such as ducks, pigeons, and falcons, which fly rapidly with continuous wing beats, tend to have moderately long, pointed wings. Many songbirds use their short, rounded wings to move with quick wing beats from perch to perch or from ground to perch. Ducks have pointed wings that, beaten at high speed, provide rapid flight for long distances. Swallows, terns, and frigate birds have long, pointed wings that enable these birds to fly and maneuver gracefully for hours with leisurely wing beats. Large herons with long, broad wings travel far with slow, measured strokes, while buzzards soar high in the sky on their long, broad wings. Gulls and albatrosses, with their long, narrow wings flapping infrequently, sail along the beaches or over the waves. Swifts and hummingbirds, with their narrow, curved wings, fly rapidly and maneuver easily. A hummingbird can whirl its tiny wings so rapidly that it can hover as it thrusts its long bill into a blossom. It can even fly backward as it leaves the bloom. The shape of a bird's tail also appears to be related to flight. The forked tails of frigate birds and terns enable quick changes of direction, and the barn swallow uses its deeply forked tail in making the intricate patterns of its graceful flight. A goshawk pursuing its prey through the forest uses its long tail in making quick turns. There is, however, such great diversity in birds' tails that the precise size and shape probably is not of critical importance. For example, ducks, with their short tails, have a swift but direct flight, but long, graduated tails are often found in rapid, direct flyers such as some parrots and doves. Woodpeckers and some other climbing birds have strong tail feathers with stout shafts, which they use as props while on the trunks of trees. The speed with which birds fly also varies greatly, and of course individual birds can vary their speed. Data on the speed of bird flight are difficult to evaluate. One of the complicating factors is that a bird's speed in relation to the ground may depend on the force of the wind. Despite the variables involved in determining a bird's speed of flight, the following generalized speeds, based on level flight in calm air, appear to be sound. The record long-range flight of a bird species in a single season is undoubtedly held by the Arctic terns that migrate from a summering ground in the Arctic to a wintering ground in the Antarctic, traveling more than 11,600 kilometers, 7,200 miles, each way. Some long-range flights are made very quickly. A blue-winged teal banded in Canada was recovered 6,100 kilometers, 3,800 miles, away in Venezuela only 30 days later. A manx shearwater, trapped at its nest in Wales and transported 5,200 kilometers, 3,200 miles, to Massachusetts and released, returned home in 121.5 days. Some very small birds regularly make long water crossing in a single flight. Ruby-throated hummingbirds fly across the more than 800 km, 500-mile, wide Gulf of Mexico, and many warblers fly from the American coast to Bermuda, a journey of about the same distance. For further information, see migration. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel, like, comment and click the bell icon to get the latest videos. Bye, friends.